Very good morning to all my dear students. Today I will be summarizing the chapter The Enemy. In this chapter, the story has been set up when Japan and America were at war with each other, and Dr. Sadao is the main character of the story. Sadao, when he was a child, if we talk about that, when he was childhood days, when he was a child, his father used to take a lot of pains teaching him. He never used to joke with him or play with him, but always on teaching him, educating him. His house was a stone house built near the beach, in the narrow beach, on the narrow beach, and there were no houses to the left and right anywhere, and their house was the only one, and it was all covered with pine trees around. And Sadao as a child used to climb those pine trees, and he always knows that he always sees that island which is near in the sea, and his father always used to tell them that, Sadao, these islands will be the stepping stone to the future of Japan. We talk about his education. When he was of 22 years of age, he was sent to America to study for higher education, and he came back at the age of 30 years. At that time, he was not only a famous surgeon, but he also became a scientist. At present, Japan is at war with America, and all the Japanese soldiers, the Japanese army, has gone to the war front, and all the doctors of Japan have also gone with the soldiers, so that if any soldier get harmed or injured, the doctors can take care of them. But Dr. Sadao was the only one who was not sent with the troop to the war. This is because of the two reasons. Reason number one is that the general was really ill. The general of Japan was really ill, and Dr. Sadao was looking after his case, and general might need an operation anytime. Therefore, Sadao was not sent with the troop. The second reason is he is discovering a chemical which we will apply on the wound. The scar of the wound will be entirely clean. There will be no scar left with the wound. Therefore, these two were the reason he was not sent to Japan. With the Japanese soldiers to the war front. I'm repeating the two reasons. Reason number one, general might need an operation anytime, and he is the one who will be doing the operation. And second reason, his discovery was in the process, which was the discovery was to make a chemical in which the scar of the wound can be cleared. There will be no scar left after applying that chemical. So because of these two reasons, he was not sent to the war front. Now, he was also married now, and his name of his wife was Hana. Hana was a very pleasant, affectionate lady, and she met Sadao in America only, but they both did not fall in love with each other until and unless they were sure that both are Japanese. And then when they came back to Japan, Sadao's father approved Hana, and then their marriage got arranged in an old Japanese style. But now one day they were standing at the veranda of the house. Sadao and Hana were standing at the veranda of the house, and they observed something from the beach. There was a lot of fog, a lot of mist, and from that mist a figure came. First that figure was staggering, and then it was crawling, and then it lied down on the sand. Both of them went there to see to the person who was lying down there. Remember that their house and beach and their house, if anybody would cross the beach and will come to the house, there's a surf which has spiked rocks on it, and if anybody will cross that sea and come towards their house, he or she will be totally injured. So the same thing was going on in the Sadao's mind, that if somebody has come to our home, to the side of our home, over across the beach, that person might be injured somewhere. And when they reached near the person was lying down with the face down, and he was right, Sadao was right. The sand on the one side was completely red because he was bleeding very badly from somewhere, right? And then Sadao turned the man over to have a better look of the face, that who is he? Maybe some fisherman or someone was there. He was not very sure. But when he turned over, they were surprised that he had golden hair and golden beard. This shows that he was a white man. He was an American. As a doctor, he now felt that I should see that where the wound is. And then the right side, the lower right side, he saw that this is the wound where it was, from where it was bleeding. and when he noticed it minutely, he saw that the gun wound is black. The wound is black. That means there's gunpowder in it. And if there's gunpowder in it, that means he was being shot by a bullet few days ago. Maybe the bullet was not taken out, therefore the wound is completely black now, but it has healed. But today, when he tried to cross the sea and come over to his house, come over to cross the beach with the spiked rocks, that rocks again reopened the wound and therefore it started bleeding again. So first of all, as a doctor, he tried to see something that from where he can stop the bleeding. And then he plucked some sea moss from the sea and applied it and covered the wound with the sea moss. And sea moss has the capability of stopping the bleeding. He covered the wound with the sea moss. But now they were confused as to what to do with this person, because the American man is their enemy. They are Japanese and he's an American, and Japan and America are at war with each other. So in that respect, he is Sadao Minhana's enemy. What to be done? But he was in unconscious state. And Sadao Minhana first thought that let us put him back into the sea. And whatever the destiny has written for him, it will happen. If the destiny wants him to save, he will be saved. If the destiny wants him to die, he will die in the sea. But let us put him back into the sea. But then on humanity never allowed them to take him back, to put him to the sea. So they both decided, so let's take him inside our house and treat him, because he was wounded. He was in unconscious state. So they both took him inside and they made him lie down in the room of Sadao's father. Sadao's father is no more, he's dead. But his room was arranged in an old Japanese style. He made them lie down there, and then Sadao knew that this person has to be operated upon. Only then he can survive, because his pulse was very low. His heartbeat was also very low. So he told Hana, you go and fetch some hot water. First we should wash him and then I will do the operation upon him. But then Hana said that I should first tell the servants that he is here, because obviously when we are doing something, we are sheltering an American man, we are operating upon him, servants will come to know. It's better that we tell them. And then they both went and tell the servants. Sadao told the other servants, and Hana told Yumi, who is the nanny. And Hana also told Yumi that please wash this white man, he is really dirty. But Yumi said, no, I will not wash such a dirty man, and that too an American. And then Hana had to wash the body, had to wash the American completely. And then Sadao came and started his operation. When he started putting his surgical instrument inside the wound to check that where is the bullet, at that time a lot of blood again started flowing from his wound. And Hana has never seen such blood, so much blood in her life. And she started puking, she started vomiting. And then Sadao did not look at Hana, and he kept looking for the bullet in the wound. And then finally he found the bullet, which was near the kidney, and Sadao took off the bullet. He was still in unconscious state, American was still in unconscious state, but he shouted in pain when the bullet was taken out, but he was still unconscious. And then they both started helping him in his recovery. They started feeding him. But this person, the prisoner of the war, that is the American person, was really very confused as to why these Japanese people are taking care of me. What do they want to do with me? What will happen in my future? The prisoner was really very surprised. And then Sadao was now confused as to what to be done, because all the servants said that you hand him over to the police, you hand this enemy to the police, otherwise we will tell everything to the police. So Sadao was really very confused as to what to be done, because as a duty of his doctor, it is his duty to save him and to really heal him together properly. But as a patriot, it was his duty to hand him over to the police, because he was a prisoner of the war. So he was being tight, he was being really confused as to what to be done. Should he complete his duty as a doctor, or should he fulfill his duty as a patriot? And he knew that if somebody will tell the police that I have given a shelter, Dr. Sadao has given a shelter to an American man, then Dr. Sadao would be really arrested and his future will be spoiled. The children's future will also be spoiled. But still, his humanitarian feeling did not allow him to hand him over to the police, and he resolved that I will save the prisoner. I will first really make him in right condition, in fine condition. Only then I will hand him over to the police. And they, but on seventh day, what happened on seventh day? Two things happened. All the servants left at one go. They together came to Hana and Sadhu and saying that we are leaving the job because they never wanted their masters to serve an enemy, to help an enemy. Therefore, they left the job. And in the afternoon, something else happened that a person came ringing the doorbell. And when Hana went to open the door, she saw a person who was standing in the police uniform, Japanese police uniform. And she really got scared. She thought that the servants might have told the police that we have sheltered an American man and the police has come to arrest Sadhu. But then the person went near Sadhu and he told that I am the messenger of the general and the general has sent me to call you because general is ill and he wants you to look after him. And then Hana says, is that all? The general says, the messenger says, what do you mean, is that all? The general is ill. How can you say, is that all? But now the Hana was a little relaxed. And then now Sadhu thought that I should do something to save Hana from this tension every time, from this anxiousness every time. So he went to the general and he told him everything, that I found this injured man unconscious state, in an unconscious state near my house. I sheltered him, I'm treating him. He told everything. And then the general says, see, I cannot afford that if you will go to the police will arrest you and I can't afford you to be arrested. Because if you will be arrested, who will take care of me? Who will operate upon me? So let me do one thing. He makes a plan, the general makes a plan, that I'll send my assassins. I'll send my private assassins and they will kill the prisoner and they will also remove his body quietly. Nobody will ever come to know where he has gone and just you keep the door open. And then Sadhu says okay, and then kept the door, get the outdoor open, outhouse doors open for three days, but nobody came, no assassin came. And this about the assassin part, he hasn't told this assassin part to Hana as well, thinking that Hana will get scared again listening to the word assassin, because it's a very big word, right? But for the next 3 days when he didn't come, no assassin came to his house, then now he planned, so that Dr. Sadhu planned that I should do something to make him escape, to make the American man escape from here. And then he arranged a boat. He also arranged a torch. He also arranged Japanese clothes. He also arranged some food, some water, and all the necessary things in the boat. And he told American, you cover your hair, cover your upper, that means head and the hair, with the cloth so that your golden hair should not be visible. And you now go here, for take the boat and that island that you are seeing in front, you go to that island. And there the Korean boat comes every second or third day. And as soon as you see any Korean boat there, you jump into the Korean boat and you will reach your country safely. And then he also told him, instructed him that I've given you all the things, all the required things you might be needing for two, three days. And if your food gets finished and you can catch fish from the island, but remember not to cook or not to make fire on the island, because if anybody will see the reflection of the fire, they'll come to know that there's somebody on the island. And I don't want to let anybody know that. And even then, if you need something, when the sun is setting in the evening, you torch twice. If you are there and you have ran out of the food, I'll make some arrangement. You flashed once. If you are there, you don't need anything. But if you are there, you just to tell me that you're still there, you have to flash one. But if you need something, you have to flash twice. And in the evening, and he went there saying thank you to him. And then in the evening, when Sadhu was looking at the island, he did not got even one flash of the light. This was sure. Now this indicated him that the Korean boat has come today only, and the American has jumped into the Korean boat, and he might have reached safely to his own country. The prisoner escaped finally. And next day, Sadhu again went to the general and he told the general that you have not sent your assassins. And then the general thought, oh my God, I really forgot. I was so ill. I was in so much pain that I forgot to send the assassins. Don't think that I'm not concerned about my country. I'm not concerned about my Japan. It's only that I was not well, right? And then he came back to his house. And now Sadhu was introspecting himself, was talking to himself, that when he was in America, he was treated so badly by all the Americans. Then why, when an American came to his house, he could not treat him badly? Why he could not hand him over to the police? Why did he help him to escape? It's just because his humanitarian feeling stood much more above the feeling of patriotism, stood much more beyond taking the revenge. His humanitarian feeling never allowed him to hand him over to the police or to let him die. That's the end of the story. This is where he saved the enemy in spite of being so much ill-treated by Americans when he was in America. Still, he saved him. That's a very big step, and that is why Sadao has really gone far above, and he has reached that milestone where humanity is the biggest serving to the society rather than fulfilling your selfish motives. Thank you. That's the end of the chapter. I hope you have liked it. If you have any comments or anything to ask, you can message me personally. Thank you.